In Australia, there are three time zones. Eastern Standard Time in the eastern states, Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria, Tasmania and the ACT. Central Standard Time in South Australia and the Northern Territory. And Western Standard Time in Western Australia. Compared to Brisbane on the east coast, where I live, Central Time is half an hour behind Eastern Time, and Western Time is 2 hours behind Eastern Time. So there's an hour and a half between Western Time and Central Time. Actually, it's a little more complicated in practice because Broken Hill in New South Wales follows Central Standard Time, and there are even some places in the eastern part of Western Australia that have their own time zone between Western Time and Central Time. But I'm going to ignore those issues here. The official labelling of these time zones is actually by comparing them to something called Greenwich Mean Time, the standard reference time for all time zones around the world. Greenwich is a place near London, actually within Greater London, and it's used as the reference for time for historical reasons, which I won't go into here. Western Standard Time is GMT plus 8, meaning 8 hours ahead of Greenwich. Central Standard Time is 9.5 hours ahead of Greenwich, and Eastern Standard Time is 10 hours ahead. GMT is also sometimes called UTC, which stands for Coordinated Universal Time. Yes, those letters are in the wrong order. That's because the acronym UTC is a compromise between English, French, and technical usage. Now in Australia, some states have daylight saving. During the summer months, the official time is moved 1 hour further ahead. Eastern Daylight Time is GMT plus 11, 1 hour ahead of Eastern Standard Time at GMT plus 10. Central Daylight Time is GMT plus 10.5, 1 hour ahead of Central Standard Time of GMT plus 9.5. However, Western Australia, the Northern Territory and Queensland do not have daylight saving time. The exact dates when daylight saving begins and ends vary a little from year to year, and sometimes from state to state. Let's try solving some problems involving time zones. Hannah flies from Sydney to Perth, leaving at 2:40 p.m. on a Friday in June. The flight takes 4 hours and 30 minutes. When will she arrive in Perth? The trick to solving this kind of problem is to work everything out in one time zone. It doesn't matter whether you use the origin or the destination, but to avoid confusion, always choose one and stick to it. I'll use the destination time zone for all the problems in this video. First question. Is there daylight saving? No, there isn't, because it's June, which is winter here in the Southern Hemisphere. So Sydney is 2 hours ahead of Perth. Now, Hannah departs at 2:40 p.m. Sydney time. What time is that in Perth? Well, Perth is 2 hours behind Sydney, so at 2:40 p.m. in Sydney, it's still only 12:40 p.m. in Perth. Now add the 4 hours 30 flight time. 12:40 plus 4 hours is 4:40, plus another 30 minutes is 5:10 p.m. Hannah will arrive in Perth at 5:10 p.m. local time. Let's try another one. Karen flew from Darwin to Melbourne, leaving at 11:45 p.m. on a Sunday in January, arriving on Monday at 5:40 a.m. How long was the flight? First, is there daylight saving? Yes, there is, because January is in the middle of summer in the Southern Hemisphere. However, we only have daylight saving in Melbourne, not in Darwin, because there's no daylight saving in the Northern Territory. So for this question, Melbourne is 1.5 hours ahead of Darwin. Karen departs at 11:45 p.m. on Sunday, Darwin time, which in Melbourne is 1.5 hours later, or 1:15 a.m. on Monday. She arrives at 5:40 a.m. on Monday. 1:15 to 5:15 is 4 hours, plus another 25 minutes gets us to 5:40 a.m. Karen's flight time was 4 hours and 25 minutes. In the bigger picture, of course, the whole globe is divided up into different time zones. As I mentioned before, they're all measured relative to Greenwich near London. Australia is between 8 and 10 hours ahead. The Americas are many hours behind Greenwich. In between, there's a special imaginary line called the International Date Line. Strange things happen if you cross the date line. Think about it. On one side of the line, it's 12 hours ahead of Greenwich, but on the other side, it's 12 hours behind. Remember, the world is really a sphere, not a flat map. We draw it flat, but it's really a sphere. Suppose it's Sunday afternoon in Australia. Then at the same moment, 10 hours back, it's Sunday morning in Greenwich. But in the US, 8 hours behind that, it's actually still Saturday evening. Let's try a simple problem first that doesn't involve crossing the date line. Amy leaves Brisbane at 5 p.m. on Friday. She lands in London 25 hours later, after a stopover somewhere in Asia or the Middle East. What day and time is it in London when she arrives? Well, Brisbane is at GMT plus 10, and London is at GMT. So Brisbane is 10 hours ahead of London. Let's work in the destination time zone again. Amy leaves at 5 p.m. on Friday, Brisbane time. 10 hours before that is 7 a.m. on Friday, London time. Amy's flight lasts 25 hours. Add 25 hours to 7 a.m. and it'll be 8 a.m. on Saturday in London when she arrives. Last problem. This one involves the international date line. Nicholas flies from Brisbane to Los Angeles, leaving at 11:30 a.m. on Tuesday. It's a 12-hour flight with no stops. When will he arrive in Los Angeles? Again, Brisbane is GMT plus 10. And if we have another look at our time zone map, Los Angeles is at GMT minus 8. Brisbane is 10 hours ahead of Greenwich, and Los Angeles is 8 hours behind that, which means there's an 18-hour time difference. Brisbane is 18 hours ahead of LA. So when Nicholas departs Brisbane at 11:30 a.m. on Tuesday, it's 18 hours earlier than that in LA. 12 hours back would be 11:30 p.m. on Monday, and another 6 would make it 5:30 p.m. on Monday in LA when Nicholas leaves Brisbane. Add the 12-hour flight time, and it will be 5:30 a.m. on Tuesday when he arrives in Los Angeles. Look at that. He arrives before he departs, in local time. It seems strange, but it's only because he crossed the international date line from west to east. He didn't really arrive before he left. It's just earlier in the local time zone at his destination. What do you think will happen on his return flight back across the date line from east to west?